This video is brought to you by SucceedSchool.com. With complete lessons and resources, assessments, learning plans and schemes of work for students, parents and teachers, for revision, for catch-up, or just to get ahead in class, visit SucceedSchool.com now for your free trial lessons. SucceedSchool.com. Learn to succeed.
Hey class, I'm Mr Thornton and I'm going to help you succeed in your GCSE and IGCSE. This lesson, the structure and formation of carboxylic acids. This topic was requested by Jake Mason and Hello World. Thanks guys. If you've got a topic you'd like me to cover, then just leave a comment below. I'm going to assume in this video you're already familiar with alkanes and alkenes. If you're not, then please check this video first before you continue, or else a good amount of the concepts I cover in this video aren't going to make sense to you. So, assuming you're familiar with alkanes and alkenes, we should already know what this molecule is called. If we take a look at it, it has two carbon atoms in its chain, so its name starts with eth or eth. Remember this table, which you do need to learn. Also, it has a single bond in the middle, not a double bond. So it's ethane, not ethene. Carboxylic acids are all based upon alkanes like this. They use the same sort of prefixes as alkanes and alkenes, but their names all end anoic acid. So before we even draw the molecular structure, we can say that the carboxylic acid based upon ethane here will be ethanoic acid. If it was based upon methane, then it would be methanoic acid. Based upon propane would be propanoic acid, and butane would give us butanoic acid. It basically works the same as the way we name alkanes and alkenes. So let's take a look at the chemical structure for ethanoic acid, which is the type of acid in vinegar, by the way. We start out with the structure for ethane, but then remove these hydrogens and replace them with two oxygens and a hydrogen, forming what we call a group of CO, O and H. There are lots of different types of groups you could put on here. For example, an OH group would make this into a type of alcohol instead. If we add this COOH group to the end of any of our alkanes, we make a carboxylic acid. Add it to methane and we get methanoic acid, as we've just said. Ethane gives us ethanoic acid, and so on. Let's now compare the chemical structures of all four carboxylic acids with the four alkanes they're based upon. As you can see, in every one of these structures, we just take the chemical structure of the corresponding alkane, take the hydrogens off the end to make room for our group, then write the two oxygens and the hydrogen. Any structure containing this COOH group is a carboxylic acid. The number of carbons tells you which one. At this point, I want to note that the chemical structure isn't drawn consistently across different exam boards or even in different textbooks. Sometimes they'll draw it as I have here, sometimes they'll draw it like this, and sometimes they'll draw it like this. All they're doing is moving around the angles of the bonds a little bit. They're all the same compound, really. Next, let's take a look at the chemical formula for a carboxylic acid. We could write the formula for ethanoic acid as C2H4O2, because that's how many of each type of atom there is in a molecule. However, chemists actually write it as CH3COOH. There's still the same number of carbons, hydrogens and oxygens in this formula, but by writing the COOH separately at the end of the formula, it actually tells us what the structure of the molecule is. There's a CH3 section first, a carbon with three hydrogens, and then there's our carboxylic acid group at the end. If you're asked to state the name of one of these compounds, then I recommend you take your hand and physically cover up the OOH. Cover the OO, just so that there's no confusion over how many carbon atoms you're dealing with. Now I've covered these atoms, you can see that there's a C2 section here, and there's another carbon on the end, so there's three carbons. That means this begins prop. And I know it's a carboxylic acid because it's got this carboxylic acid group, so it must be propanoic acid. Again, physically cover up the OOH, cover the OO, at least until you get used to the naming system. This works for the chemical formula, as I've just demonstrated, and it also works for the diagrams of the chemical structure too, like this. Covering up the oxygens and the hydrogens makes it very clear that there's four carbon atoms here, so this one must be butanoic acid. There's a couple of ways to make a carboxylic acid like ethanoic acid, but both of them work by oxidizing the relevant alcohol, in this case, ethanol. If we look at the structure of the two molecules here, you can see that an oxygen has just stolen two of the bonds that were connected to hydrogens, and another oxygen will have then joined to these two displaced hydrogens, forming a water molecule. If the seal in a wine bottle isn't airtight, perhaps because the cork is damaged, the oxidation can happen slowly over time, and the expensive bottle of wine someone thought was improving with age could actually steadily be turning into vinegar. Aside from just allowing natural fermentation to turn ethanol into ethanoic acid, we can also push the oxidation process along with an oxidizing agent, basically a compound which is carrying oxygen atoms to add into the ethanol. The one usually used is a colourless solution called acidified potassium manganate 7. All you really need to know about it is that in its formula, KMnO4, there are four oxygen atoms just waiting to join our ethanol molecules and oxidise them. So, now we know what a carboxylic acid is and how it's formed. We need to know a bit about their properties, and I'll cover that in an extra video I'm going to upload this Saturday with a joint lightning round for both videos going live this Sunday. Make sure to watch out for both this weekend. I hope that video really helped you. If it did, it'd be great if you let me know in the comments. Remember to like, subscribe, and hit the bell to get a notification the next time I upload a video. If you check the description, I've got links to my revision guides, to Snap Quiz, that's my revision website and app, and to succeedschool.com. That's my website with full lesson plans, schemes of work, and end of unit tests for both teachers and students. I've also got links in the description to my Twitter, my Instagram, my Patreon if you want to support the channel, and there's links to my other YouTube channels, Not School and Not School Plays. You can also click just here to subscribe to this channel, and you can click here to check out this related video. Good luck in your GCSEs and IGCSEs, and thanks very much for watching.